Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. With me right now is Nicole Brewster, CEO at Renforth Resources. Nicole, good to see you. Good morning. How are you?
Hey, I'm great. How are you today?
I'm good. Thanks for asking. Lots to get to today. Let's first start off with your Parbec project. You have completed the final twin hole with multiple mineralization intervals at this specific project. So tell us a bit more about what you found there.
So we put out assays for Parbec 21132, and again, mineralized intervals, which was actually what was expected because that was the final hole in our 15,000 plus meters program that was a twin. So we were literally twinning in that instance. If I recall correctly, it was a 1986 drill hole or 87 33, I think. And we got gold. You know, we can't fault getting gold, and we expected to get gold. So the fact that we did receive the mineralized interval, it causes us to consider the twin a successful twin. The gold that we got is comparable to the, in terms of location and in terms of tenor, like 11.75 meters of 3.3 grams per ton gold. It's comparable to the hole we were twinning, and that was the final twin in the program. Each twin we deem successful, which is notable because our May 2020 mineral resource estimate for Parbec excludes all the drilling which took place between 1986 and 1993 in terms of the assay values for those drill holes. So with these outright twin holes in combination with other holes that are drilled in proximity to the historic holes, everything hangs together, for lack of a better way to say it. It replicates as we would expect it to. So that causes us to consider the historic data valid and therefore eligible for inclusion in any upcoming mineral resource estimate recalculation for Parbec. And it's more gold. Gotta love putting out a gold press release. 15 drill holes to go to be publicly released for Parbec. I do have incomplete results for several of those 15 holes, but we're waiting to get an entire hole to continue to release.
Okay, so we'll look forward to those remaining holes.
Lots more info to come.
We'll look forward to that. And I do want to get to your Suramu project. You've also received assay data from there as well. So what were some of the highlights here?
Well, I didn't put it out. There are no highlights for public consumption yet. We've received assay data, but it's partial holes. And Suramu is so interesting because we're doing discovery work. This property was never really looked at with any seriousness before. Several people operated in the corner we're in. So Suramu's 260 square kilometers. We're at Victoria West, which is in kind of the bottom left corner of the property, bottom southwest end. And Victoria West has mineralization that's been historically demonstrated and verified by our initial surface prospecting over 5 kilometers. We drilled off 2.2 kilometers. If memory serves, it was 18 holes. Subsequent to those, we did do another 4 holes. We've only put out assays from a couple hundred meters that we drilled last October, but we're going to have very little information over a very small area in a very big mineralized occurrence. So what I did say in the press release was that we are getting the data. The technical team we've put together, which has, you know, the working field geologists, the expertise of my board, as well as the expertise of some regional experts and gray-haired guys, including Dr. Jim Franklin. We're going to wait till we have all the data and they all get a chance to look at it and opine on it, because I think these are some very important first steps, and we want to make them correctly because you only get one chance to make a first impression. So rest assured, shareholders, assays are coming in and we're looking at them. And we've already told you we have visible nickel, copper, and zinc sulfides in each of the drill holes over the 2.2 kilometers. And then when we undercut two of them just recently, the visible mineralization got better. but we're only going to put out the assays when we can deliver the entirety of the data package with some interpretation wrapped around it, as opposed to Parbec, where I just put out each hole as I get it, because it's more gold. Every hole is more gold, and we're drilling off a deposit. And I give people the cross sections to see where the holes are, but Suramo is a different cattle altogether. So stay tuned.
Oh, we definitely will. And before I let you go, I do want to talk about the property that you did divest to O3 Mining. That was the Danan Pershing property. Can you maybe just explain why you did sell that off and what value that in turn brings to Renforth?
For sure. There are a couple reasons. Well, there's really one big reason why. Danan Pershing had originally been optioned to Chalice Mining, and the option was subsequently acquired by O3. So O3 brought the option to completion, which took them to an 80% ownership interest, which left Renforth with a 20% participating interest. It's important to note that what that means is if O3 elected to do exploration on the Danan Pershing property, they would be the deciding mind. We would have no ability to affect the choices that they would make in terms of how much they would spend or the timing of that work, but we would have to pony up 20% of the cost of that work. So we wouldn't be controlling the financial timelines, which is not a great position to be in as far as I'm concerned. We also would not have any particular material interest. And Danan Pershing is an early stage property. There is mineralization present, but it's far and away from being a resource or anything that would even start to look like it had economic potential. So you're looking at a long timeline, a lot of spending. And if we don't spend, we dilute to zero and it could happen pretty quickly. So in discussion with O3, we decided that to clean the property up, we would sell them the residual 20% interest we held. And we received a total of $175,000 in cash and shares, representative of their final option payment, as well as a nominal payment for the 20%. Which otherwise, frankly, we would have just devolved to a 0% ownership interest the next time they did work. So we've got some O3 shares, so exposure to their success with the property or their other properties, frankly. And we got some cash in the till, and that's never a bad thing. So, you know, that's the net benefit at the end of the day. And it refines our portfolio, streamlines our asset base, and it perhaps makes it clear to people where our focus is at Renforth. So, you know, that was just a maintenance issue, so to speak.
Definitely makes sense. And we'll look forward to chatting with you again soon. Nicole, thank you so much.
Thanks very much. Have a wonderful day.